I'm actually so sad that Juan Carlos left.
He was amazing.
He was amazing, but he asked if anybody watched The Devil Wears Prada. I saw The Devil Wears Nada, but it definitely wasn't the same movie. Where are all the potheads at?
Yeah!
Good. I quit smoking pot a long time ago. Because I used to get so fucked up on it, I would like get high and I would go masturbate in the closet for like 18 hours. Yeah, what was wrong with me? I stopped being high after the first floor. Like, that says something about me. And I just smoked weed actually for the first time in a while the other night. And I have a question, like, you guys smoke weed. Some people said they do. Do you guys have that friend that has like such good weed, like every time you smoke it, no matter what you're doing or where you are, you just fucking leave? Because I did that the other night. I was with a whole bunch of people and I smoked this weed and I just went home. I didn't say goodbye to nobody. They were so drunk, they still thought I was there. So I kind of got off the hook on that one. Left a friend down there. He had to walk home drunk. He called me the next day, he's like, dude, I need to walk home. And I'm like, dude, I had to go home. I went out to the parking lot, and I'm like, oh, I'm going to chill for a minute. I'm too fucking high to be in this room. And I walk out to my car, and a fucking cop pulls up, and I'm like, I'm not sitting in my fucking car. I just drove my ass home. Like I said, I woke up in the morning, got hella text messages, like, where the fuck are you? I walked in the dark. So I gotta tell you guys, anybody seen me yet?
4 years!
Wow. That was some conviction right there.
I thought that was a razor hand.
I like that. You know what's crazy? Like, I know women and shit, they like to be like, oh, I want a guy to be honest. I want him to, like, really, like, tell me what's on his mind. And I wish I could be honest with women. I wish I could really tell them, like, what was really on my mind. Which is the simple fact of, to me, they're kind of like a Rubik's Cube. I want to fuck with them for a while, but the last thing I'm trying to do is figure them out.
Yeah. That was a good one, shit.
Yeah, thank you, man.
Yeah.
And you know what I hate too? Like, when I see a bunch of people, because, like, I gotta be honest, I've looked the same since fucking, like, high school. Like, ninth grade. This face hasn't changed. And people come up and they go, God, you really look so good. And I think, like, what the fuck? Did I just get done smoking crack for 5 years? Like, you walk up, like, hey, you look good. Like, I just kicked my meth habit. Like, what the fuck is the deal with people? And like I said, I'm sorry, like, I look the same since whatever. I see people, like, 10 years later, and I have no fucking clue who they are. And I used to have a house, it was like a party house. Everybody came to it. We had this like legendary Pimpin' and Hoes party. And then I see people and they're like, dude, that fucking party was amazing. Like, I don't remember any of it. I'll be honest, when I woke up in the morning, my kitchen was blown. Like, I went to go to my like refrigerator, I just slid. And I like stopped in front of the dish. Like, I was like, what the fuck happened? Like, that's what happens when you go through like so much blow in one night. I was high within the first 20 minutes of that party. I gotta tell you what, like I said, I'm not a big drug person anymore. And a lot of people go on drug binges, coke binge. I kind of went on a joke binge one time. Yeah, it was crazy. The come down was brutal. I was thinking to myself, maybe next time I'm not gonna do so many lines. My mother passed away when I was younger, and I've been thinking about her a lot lately, which is weird, because I don't think about her, like, you know, on a consistent basis, more than I should. And I realized, like, her methods of, like, raising me were really odd. Like, when I got in trouble, she beat me with a wooden spoon. When I said a curse word, she washed my mouth out with summer's eve. Oh my god. And I gotta tell you guys too, like, I wrote this joke, like, I write a lot of jokes, and I post them on Facebook, and I wish people would stop taking me so seriously. I put this one the other day, and I was like, dude, the great thing about having a girlfriend who is a makeup artist is awesome, because she can make herself look like anybody but herself. And this girl, she texts me the next day and she's like, dude, could you introduce me to your girlfriend? I'm looking for makeup techniques. So I hit her back and I'm like, yeah, it was a total joke. Like, I don't have a girlfriend. And she's like, yeah, I thought so. It was a pretty dick thing to say. And she's like, yeah, I feel super embarrassed. So instead of, you know, being a dick, I was like, don't worry, like, hella people text me that today. She hits me back, she goes, really? I go, no. You were the only one. And my dad, I didn't get to see him much in my life. And I guess it's kind of a good, kind of a bad thing. But I learned a couple of things from him that was pretty awesome. I learned that how to go out and get milk and never come back. I pulled that trick a couple times. And I was out with a friend not too long ago, and he's playing pool, and he's shooting the ball in every hole, and I fucking suck at pool. And he's like, sinking every shot, and I'm like, dude, how did you do that? He's like, oh, well, it's the game my father taught me how to play. I'm like, that's so crazy. The only game my father taught me to play was hide and seek. And he's so good at it, I never found him. I want to tell you guys, thank you to Eric for putting this together. I have a show this Friday at Jasper's. I got a lot of good comedians. Juan Carlos will be there, my friend over there. There's flyers over there, so if you guys come out, we have a phenomenal lineup. And I want to thank you guys for my time.